in it for all of you. Three key things today. Well, you're going to learn how to craft paragraphs that can connect, that can explain, that can help you to see things better and get your point across. And we're going to learn how to enhance the impact. When people read it, they go, yes, I know what to do. And finally, what is old-fashioned archaic? You see the big word there, archaic, is old-fashioned. But a lot of us like to write big words to distance ourselves from the reader, that we are better than you. And nope, that's not how we're going to do it. How are we going to be particular about punctuation? Should we have comma after dear John? Is there a comma? No, no comma. I will clarify all your doubts in this free webinar. Good round. Okay, let's carry on. As many of you know, my 粉丝, my approach, I'm not just going to like bleh, vomit out the concepts. You might as well read a book. I'm going to raise some awareness through activities, through videos where it sets you thinking. What are the possible mistakes that you could be making? And then when I introduce, you go, see, I already know. At least you know. Or if you go, oh, OMG, I didn't know. And you also know that you didn't know. So there'll be a awareness first. So awareness followed by the content. And then we'll have some exercise together to round off. Okay, today no role plays, rest assured. I know you're like my Barbara Lee role play. Today we're focusing on writing. So we'll finish off with an email and we will critique it together and make it robust and beautiful. All right, let's begin. I know many of my 粉丝 have told me that their children love this part because it is Kahoot time. I love the music. So everybody, you know what to do, right? Whip out your phones. I prepared a nice Kahoot quiz for you. And that's where you will all share how you see yourself. What do you hope to learn out of it? So it will give us a quick. All right, the game pin is coming right up. Those of you are doing this the first time, just remember you go into the browser, key in. Actually, no need the www. I just put kahoot.it. Oh, some of you are in. And then you key in this game pin, 460596, and come up with your nickname. Let's be creative. Let's see what nicknames we have. I love the music. Strangely, the Kahoot music just suddenly died. But anyway, let's begin. The first question. As secretaries and administrators, we need to be good at everything. Is that true or false? Thank you. transition party. For the first time in a long, long time, we have more of us who say it is true. Well, this is my opinion, because this is a poll. It's not a right or wrong or set by the government. Because if you try to be good at everything, you will go crazy, gila, chisin, pingsan, I tell you. But what you need to be good at is the R word, resourceful. Agree, agree? You may not be good at everything, but you know who is good at everything. So you have to be the person that can connect the people, and that makes you a super secretary and power administrator. Who agrees? Say A-A-A-Y-E. Yeah, yeah, right? It doesn't mean that you have to be longchong everything very good. No? Just agree? Totally agree. Thank you. Second, oh, that's for fun. Let's see who is the fastest finger. Y-L. Okay, no prize for this. Just for fun. Bragging rights. Second question. How do you see your ability to do your job as a secretary or administrator? Be better. I wonder if I'm in the right job. Congratulations, you are super good. Yeah, somehow I always get the smallest percentage here. I think people are very humble in general, at least in Asia. In the States, I imagine, it's like, we are super good, fantastic, unbelievable. And we have the most of us feel that we can do better. Oh, so humble. 42, yeah, pretty okay. Three of you, I know, right? Sometimes we wonder and doubt ourselves, am I in the right job? As a matter of fact, I hope that you can discover whether this is in your right job, because if it's not, you get to get out of the market, né? Because it requires so much resilience, so much mental power, so many other things that you need as a secretary. That's why I salute all of you here. And the next question is third of the final one, because today's focus is on writing skills. Great writing skills. Most of you have half-half, sometimes good, sometimes bad. Six of you, tokong, very good, gila. 10 of you, quite bad. People don't usually don't understand what I'm writing. I know, right? You write to them, you say, what do you mean? Then to you, it's like, what do you mean? What do you mean? It's so obvious. Can you read properly? Right? We get really upset, but maybe it's the way we write. And three of you, Maxine is here today to help you raise your game. Final question. Those of you who have joined me before, you know it is the word cloud time. I'm your answer. One keyword. One fun. One feel better. Thank you. Halloween came earlier. Eight. Prepare your cameras, people. It will be a nice cloud. Ready, 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 ready. What would you hope to get out of today's webinar? What's the biggest thing I wanted? Knowledge? OMG! I feel like a prophet. I feel good. Oh, let's take a quick look. Writing email do to be better. Motivation. Oh, you got that. Writing skill rental, definitely got that. Communication, right? Clearly, teamwork. No, no. Well, teamwork in department. That will be topic for another day, my friend. And learning, writing tip. All right, consider it done. Except for one that we say that learn from an expert. Well, I will share best practices. I won't dare say I'm an expert, but maybe I am. So let's take a look. Who is the top three fastest fingers just for fun? And the fastest finger is... I just love the pop for this music. I love the fanfare. Because I don't get to see and hear y'all in person, right? So I imagine the fanfare is for me. Like, thank you, stop it, thank you. There you go. So let's do a quick recap of what we saw. The key things that all of us want to learn is about writing, and majority of us are half-half. We are sometimes good, we are sometimes not good. So today, for those who are half-half, let's focus on how to be good most of the time. Those of you who are already super good, or at least you see yourself as super good, there's always something new to learn. You agree? And those of us that I need help, I'm here. And those who can do better, absolutely. So let's start with where I left off earlier on. My grandfather's time from London. They write things in the same old way. But as we talk about modern rules in business writing, so let's set the stage correctly. Do you talk like, hey, John, as per our conversation yesterday, Hong, can you please help me to submit a document? Who talks like that as per our conversation? So when you cannot even say it, cannot even mouth it, don't write it. So it's for rule number one is, if you can say it, you can write it. You don't say that, oh, I hope the memo I sent you this morning finds you well. Who talks like that? Right? So we talk about, then how should we write it? Well, the best practice comes later. I'm building awareness now. If you are like that, you go like, I'm like that. I write like that, you know. And of course, most of us like to write very old-fashioned English. I seek your understanding. Did you know my grandfather told my mother told me, it is in the olden times, in the 1930s or even like many, many centuries ago, the people, when they ride on horses, they go, good book. My lord, I seek your understanding. They were really seeking last time. Okay? In modern world, with technology, there's no such thing as I seek. So if you're one of those who are like, I seek you, and it makes me sick. So please drop the seek. It's old-fashioned. We'll talk about that later. I have a little segment there where I prepared some old-fashioned statements. I bet you most of you are still using them. And the final main rule, which is quite refreshing for many of us because we didn't think of it that way. We have to aim to build relationships. In the past, email writing or business writing is meant to distance the relationships that I am better than you. But today, no. You're writing emails to invite someone to come to your event, invite your or ask to pitch an idea to your boss, or to get buy-in from your stakeholders. You need to aim to build relationships. So that's a great concept, but that comes the how, right? So there are four what's for you to think about before you write. So by the way, if you like, you can take a picture, huh? If you wait for the YouTube video, I don't know when. So the first thing is, what is my, okay, your guess, I don't know, just, let's make it a little interactive. Let's get, oh, the song makes me so kanchong. I know, right, me? It's fun and exciting and exhilarating. At the same time, it's like, stop it, I'm stressed. Okay, coming back to this. What's your purpose? Yes, intention. There you go, spot on. Janice, you said purpose. Su Ying Chi, you said purpose. What is my purpose? Most of us don't think about it, right? Especially when we are angry. Someone sends you an email and accuses you of something and you write back and you go, how can you say that? you didn't really think, what is my purpose? Is your purpose really to just rant at the person, to scold that person? If you think further, your purpose could be to clarify that misunderstanding. But because you didn't think about it, you let your emotions overrule you, it comes out all gibberish, all inconsistent sentences, and it just makes you look emotional, irrational. And what will the person who received your email do? Ignore and say, emo email. So think about it. I wish I had more time today because I would even talk about complaint emails. Do you know I'm a complaint letter queen? Especially when I was in sales and insurance, right? I'm also the claims queen. Where other advisors cannot get claims from their clients and I just need to write my power letter. 100% of the time, I get the claim approved. And in recent years, my dangerous driving, I'm a good driver now, promise. I used to have a lot of speeding tickets. With my power email writing, I always get it either waived or the points removed or even just have a reduction in the fine. Please don't send me your complaint emails or your fines. Huh? But if you're my student, I can do it for free. Second thing, what is the information I need to provide to the reader? What is it that they want to know? So this one is straightforward, so I don't have to ask you. Because all of us are very good at this. In fact, we do it right away. I hope this email finds you well. You wanted this information. We vomit everything out, right? And we don't even have any proper opening, no clear purpose, no context. You expect your reader to scroll down to see what was the email conversation previously. And many of us don't even bother to edit the email heading. It is still about a topic that was four conversations ago. As a result, the receiver, the reader looks at it, huh, what are you talking about? They spend half the time trying to figure out what is the context. Why are you giving me this information? Time lost, message misconstrued, inefficient. Now, the third one, most people don't know. Okay, let's try, hit it. What do you want your reader to, what about what you write? Come, tell me, understand. Possible, understand. Most of us would think understand. No, yes, to understand. Well, along those lines, but it's not just to understand, but what do you want them to think? What do you want them to feel? Some of us, I don't care how they feel. Well, think about it. I've shared in my previous sessions that people are different. The Taiwan style people, they're the emotional people. Some of us, especially when we are very people person, right? We go, hi, John. Hope this email finds you well. You're old fashioned, right? And regarding the document that you needed, I spent 2 weeks trying to do research and I put together and then I hope this will be really helpful and all the best to your meeting today. And then cheers. And then what does John reply? Okay, thanks. And then this emotional person said, I wrote so much to him. I even asked about his day. I even wish him the best. I told him I spent 2 weeks to actually do it. And all he did, look, he wrote, okay, thanks, Wong. And that's where they get really upset. What are they thinking? What are they feeling? They feel that you don't appreciate them. You see, as a secretary and an administrator, right, you write to people all the time. And from what I know, a lot of them don't like the secretary, don't like the PA because they say you're cold, you're very task-oriented, you don't care how they feel when they read. So think about it. You do need to think and feel how they will think and feel. And finally, the final one, again, some of us put here, put there, put everywhere, long chung, and then they go hide and seek, right? What do you want the reader to what? What's the final one? Give me one more. The no feel is an earlier question, right? What do you want the reader to... to do, there you go, Inju. You got it, you hit it. What do you want them to do? I have a client previously, I think it was 2 years ago, there was a Taipei earthquake, right? Taipei 101, my client is BNP Paribas, and their office is within 101. Okay? And this HR manager, she got a secretary to write to me. She said, Maxine, this email is to inform you that there is an earthquake in Taipei today. My training is like 2 days away. Yeah? There's an earthquake in Taipei today. Thank you. Then I was like, so what do you want me to do? Pray that the earthquake doesn't happen again? Do you want me to postpone my trip? Do you want me to find out what's the situation? What do you want me to do? She just wrote, but I know what she's thinking, being a people person. She's a HR, she's been told, right? Their job is just to inform me, just FYI, just so you know. So if you go there and there's an earthquake and you die, don't blame me that I didn't tell you there's an earthquake. But what do you want the reader to do? Perhaps even just the word, please take care while you are there. It is an action. You don't just give information, you don't care how I think and feel, and you don't tell me what to do. That is a rubbish email. Oh, I'm so emotional about that because it's a true case. Huh? I was so angry. I was like, what do you want to do? But of course, I figured it out later. Now, let's have some fun because I am sure many of you do that. Okay, let's give it a number. I should give it a number. This one is 1, 2, 3. Yeah? Can you please write in my chat box there, which ones are you currently using? 1, 2, or 3. One is the above mentioned, the below mentioned, above, below. The second one is we refer to your email data, da 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 da. Or please furnish us with your details, all of them. Thank you for your honesty. I know, right? We refer. It is super old-fashioned. Okay, let's talk about modern. The above-mentioned document. Do you need to write above-mentioned below? On top of that, another old-fashioned word here is dispatched. Dispatched. This, again, is an old-fashioned term, huh? Where they dispatch documents and then they put it on horses. They pshat on the horse. Then they dispatch the horse, huh? But no, in modern way, how do we write it? Can anybody give it a shot before I share with you the answers? Awareness partner, remember, I'm not just going to tell you, otherwise I'll just print it out and you can go and do. Attached is the document. Dispatch the motorcycle. I like you, Angel, you're funny. What else? Okay, any more? Come on, I'll wait for 30 more seconds. The above mentioned document will be dispatched to you today. How can we rephrase the whole thing? It is super old fashioned. Dispatch the motorcycle. Come on, any more? The document will be sent to you today, Su Ying Shi. Okay, please excuse me if I pronounce your name wrongly. Yeah? Su Ying Shi, yes, document is sent to you today. You will receive your docs today. There you go. There's no need to say above, below. Instead of dispatch, a more modern word is we will courier. Some will say we will send the document to you. You will receive the docs today. I like that too. And that's T-Y-N-G. I've included the document for your convenience. So much better than the above mentioned document will be dispatched. All right, courier, the word courier is more high class than I send to you, like send by Grab Ride or whatever. So we want to make it sound more authentic, high class. We will courier the document to you by today. The second one, which I mentioned earlier on, we refer to your email data. Comments. This is old fashioned, by the way. What do you mean? I've been writing it like forever. That's my point, huh? Forever. Referring to your email, we will send the document. Okay, we'll move on to the next one. Huh? What's the next one? We refer to your email dated. Very old fashioned. Your email to us on. Okay, you're almost there, Janet. There are missing words before your email is. Okay, before I comment on that, next question I'm going to ask all of you regarding the second sentence here, right? I can tell you up front that the sequence is wrong. How can I say right or wrong, right? It's based on best practices in England. There is a certain sequence in how you write the dates. So instead of, with reference to the email dated, okay, that is still pretty old-fashioned, not modern enough, but it's still, just playing with the words. I'll give you a clue. The word refer can be like chop off. You don't need the word refer. Your email data. Okay, yeah. So that is something in front. But let's talk about that later because no one seems to be getting it. Your email of 5th April, based on your email on 5th April. All right. They are all something. They are all closer to that. But it has to be a sentence. It has to be a sentence. All of you sound like you're going to write like halfway of the sentence. Previously as your email, it has to be a sentence. Whatever I replace here is a complete sentence. We receive your email on, yes, we receive your email. That is more modern, thank you. Let's talk about the date. Okay, I wish I had more time. Let's move on. Huh? I show you. Thank you for your email. There's no need to refer this as per there, no in reference to that. Just thank you. That's the modern way. Whoever calls you, thank you for your call. Not as per our conversation just now. Thank you. Instead of the sending an email, in reference to your email, you sound like you're distancing for yourself. You see the difference? Rule number three, we aim to build relationships. So don't in reference, you sound like the Tsing Hu, the garment. But thank you for your email. And this comes to the part where I talk about the sequence. 5th April. By the way, this superscript TH in the past 10 years, it has been agreed in the world of writing. We drop them. Let's drop the ST, so it's 5, yeah? But you'll notice that I put the month first. Let me ask you, how many months in a year has the date? 5. Every month, right? You will have that 5th of Jan, 5th of Feb, 5th of March, so on and so forth. But how many Aprils do we have in a year? 1. You see the logic? Because when a reader reads your email, the first thing that hits him or her, they'll be thinking, which month is she talking about? Especially when you're crossing over a month, right? Is it this month or was it last month? So when you say April, they will know, oh, she's talking about last month. Then they talk about 5th. So it is faster for them to receive the information. The mind doesn't go wild and the message is clearer. Get it? Yeah. That's the logic. By the way, I figured out the logic myself and I studied it. They all said that it's the way. I'm not the type that say you tell me it's the way, right? I need a logic behind it. And it makes sense, right? Every month has a 5, but only 1 April in a year. So you write the month first, followed by the date, and then the year. Cool? Third one, please kindly furnish us. You think about furniture. Huh? Furnish us with your details. So let's see. Is your, as per your email, HQ, that is old fashioned. So thank you for your email. Does this mean that the Americans got it right all along? No one thought that they, the Balik, the man. You are right, Inju. They got it right all the while. Just that for us, somehow, you look everywhere. Everyone puts the dates first, including Aventis. They put the date of the workshop. I always strongly recommend you put the month first. So kindly furnish us. Thank you, Grace. Please kindly furnish us. The old-fashioned word here is furnish. Nobody uses that anymore. So what word can you use? Even boss do it. Because your boss old-fashioned. No. Of course, you don't criticize your boss. Just that when you reply, you don't have to copy your boss. Bosses don't expect you to write in the way they do. But do write in a way that they will understand. We shall talk more in a while. Please provide us with the information. Janet, spot on. Please provide applause for Janet and some of you who wrote that. Don't use kindly because it's an angry tone. I know it's sarcastic, right? Kindly appreciate that they all have taken on new meanings recently. Yeah? Very sarcastic. So please provide us with your details. There you go. And now another 3. Yeah? Come. Let's call it 1, 2, 3 again. The first one is please find and close. Should you require any, we seek your kind understanding. 1, 2, 3. Which one are you guilty of writing? 1, 2, or 3? Or 1, 2, 3? 2 and 3. Thank you for saying all of them. Oh gosh, I was guilty of them until I learned the modern way. Please find enclosed here with our fee charges. Enclosed. What would be a better way? Please find enclosed. Come, any ideas? Please find enclosed. Old fashioned. Here with some more. Here with is an old fashioned statement. What do you write? Please find enclosed. Attach. Okay, attach. Okay, let's take a look here. Here are our fee charges. There is no need to write. Of course, if it's an attachment, you say we have attached our fee charges. But if you are putting the fee charges within the email, there's no need to say enclosed here. Because enclosed is referring to they present the information right after the sentence. So you just put, here are our fees. Ta-da! You can see it, right? Second one, should you require any clarifications, please do not hesitate to call us, please. They are not shackled at their ankles. When they want to call you, they will call you. It's like, don't hesitate. It's like, I want to break free. Okay, there's no need to ask them to don't hesitate. They want to call you, they will call you. So how do you write it in the modern way? Append is the, well, append is an old-fashioned word. Mary, drop the append, just like the appendix. You don't need it. Should you require any further clarifications? You write that all the time because other people get in touch. I can be reached. Okay, that sounds a lot more personable, Priscilla. I like that. We can be reached. Please call us. Yes, Elaine. Don't need to say should you require. Please call us. Please contact us for any. Here comes the word. Some will argue clarifications or clarification. Okay, let me clarify the air here. You can Google it if you don't believe me. It is an uncountable noun. Just like sheep, like stationery, there is only clarification. But just like the word fish, right? I go scuba diving, right? When I see the fish, if they're all salmon, right? I said, wow, that is a cool school of fish because they're all the same type of fish. But because I'm scuba diving, sometimes I will see pomfrets here, I will see octopus there, or different types of fishes. So here, in the context of an email, because it is that email, you will only use it as an uncountable noun. Please contact us for any clarification. Unless you're the government with all kinds of departments and all kinds of clarifications, you can safely just know for email writing is always singular. Now you know, right? Very clever. Go tell more people. The third one, we seek. This is the old fashioned. We seek your kind understanding. Someone said earlier on, kind is very sarcastic now. How about please let us know if you need any clarification? Yes, you think that is fine. Good. Definitely more personable than should you require that you're distancing. That is a passive way of writing. But please call us. Feel free. Okay, drop the feel free, man. Angela, feel free is a joke. I was like, feel free. They will call you. No need to tell them to feel free. Please call us if you need any clarification. Don't feel free. It's unnecessary. Take it out. Hope you may understand. Oh. Well, they may not. So, but definitely better than the seek word. Here is, thank you for your understanding. Some will argue, but they didn't understand me yet. How can I say thank you for your understanding? It is business writing. Okay? They may not have said yes yet, but you can say upfront, thank you, or we look forward to your kind understanding, or we seek your kind understanding. No need to say, thank you for your kind understanding. Cool. All right, picture moment if you like. The old-fashioned way and the modern way of writing. Okay, we have about 16 minutes. I'm moving on. Okay, I'm going to skip this video because it takes a few minutes. I have so many good tips for y'all to learn about. Okay, let me go to the next one. Let's critique this email together. Okay, this is the part where we're going to introduce an email writing format. Some words that we learned just now is old-fashioned. Okay, over here. Okay, let's see. I will see. Okay. Oops, sorry. Oh no. Can y'all key into the book first, a month first for date? Okay, month first for date. What do you mean? So it's like May. Today is the May 21st, 2020. All right, everybody, can you put in the group chat, dear Miss Tan, should we put dear or should we put hi? This is email. Letter writing is always dear, but email writing, is it dear or hi? That's been an argument. Dear, month first. Okay, we're still at the old topic. Come. When we talk about, excuse me. Oh, you put dear or put hi. All right, here is the clarification. Email. Is it a formal document or an informal document? Well, many will say it's formal. Well, here's the answer. It is an informal form of writing. A formal one will be in the letter and you send the bird to fly. Okay, no bird nowadays. You send the postman to send it. That is formal writing. So letter writing, minutes writing, report writing, they are formal documents. Email, which is short for electronic mail, is an informal form of writing. which is why it is acceptable to use short forms. It is, for example, the month, you don't have to spell out the whole month. Instead of March, you can put M-A-R because it's informal. So that leads me to the point here is Dear Miss Tan is a formal way, but modern writing is Hi Miss Tan. And I remember 2 years ago when my son was applying for his polytechnic, right? He wanted to skip the whole junior college route. He wants to jump from secondary, poly, and then university. So he applied to the polys, and one day he came back and said, Mom, I received an email from Ngee Poly and Singapore Poly. They have both accepted me for the next round of interview. I said, congratulations, baby! And I replied the emails. I was like, huh? Do you need to reply? He said, yeah, I just said something nice to thank them. I said, Mommy is so proud of you. I bet you out of the few hundred students, none of them actually replied with a thank you email. Come, show mommy, what did you write? So I read his email. It goes something like this. The email from the Ngee Poly is, Dear Cohen Sim, congratulations. You have passed the first round and moving on to bring along your code because it's going to be cold during the interview. And then regards, right? And then sign off by Mrs. Florence Tan. So I said, okay, Zai, son, show me your email. And then he wrote, because Florence Tan, right? So he wrote, Dear Mrs. Florence Tan. I said, Cohen, let mommy explain to you. Email is an informal form of writing. So you do not need to write dear because it's old fashioned. Then my son is the India style. You know, if you all remember, she's the thinking type. He said, but mom, she wrote to me, Dear Cohen Sim. Since she dear me, shouldn't I dear her back? I was like, they are so clever. It's true. Mommy forgot that. So here's the rule of exception. Some of you will say, but my bosses write dear to me. If they dear me a high back, it shows disrespect, right? It's true. Because many of our bosses, senior management, they still live in the old generation. If they are writing in the old-fashioned way, they dear you and you high back, they say, hi, nigga tower. Hide your head, they will show or they will perceive it as disrespect. But if you're the one initiating emails to your staff and all that, you write dear, they will say you're very old-fashioned PA. So you all get the rule here. So here, let's coming back to this. So we mentioned earlier on, miss and all the TH, no more dots. And should there be a comma here? No comma, because when you have a comma, it is for a sentence. This is not a sentence. It is a greeting. Right? Dear Miss Tan, there's no comma. Some will say, "Aiyah, put comma, put dot, won't die." It's true, you won't die. That's what my teacher who taught me when I went for, she's a British lady, by the way. And she said, the comma is like vegetables in your teeth. They just cloud your professionalism. I thought, okay, I remember that since then. So unnecessary comma, full stop, take it out, cut. This again, old fashioned, right? I refer to your email. We all know, right? We don't want to say thank you for your email. Dated, we put the month first, take out the TH, and then there's a comma and the year. Oh, the second part, I regret. This is in my full day course. I'll share with you the whole list of negative words. Some of us, I regret. I regret is like, what? Did someone die? Did your dog die? Did someone die in your family? Now, I regret if I'm unable to accept. The client who sent this to you will feel very rejected. On top of that, say, unfortunately, what? Your boss died too? But when you say, unfortunately, it's a very negative word. Chop. And then please do not hesitate. Again, another old-fashioned phrase. To call me for further clarifications. Another error here, no S. And the most boring ever that many of you agreed, thank you. And then regards, and then Jenny Tan, PA. Wrong. So before I share with you the best practice, I have about 10 minutes. So I'm going to share with you the framework, and then we will revisit the improved version. Right? So before we could, everybody take a picture of this whole email, because I'm going to show you the corrected version. Okay, ready? While I take a sip of water. Oh, thank you, Grace. Oh, I love Grace. Always so appreciative. Next. Email writing format. I'm going to give you this even though this is a free workshop. People pay thousands of dollars just to learn the format. Here you go. I'm giving to you out of love. The P word. Remember the first one. What is your purpose of writing? The P is for purpose. You have to state it up front. And then what is the information, right? That's where you list the information. That's where you share with them. This is what I want you to know. And then what do you want them to think or feel, and what do you want them to do, right? In fact, what you want them to think or feel is all under here. And the action is what do you want the reader to do, or what will you be doing? And then you close off with a nice note. Wait for it, wait for it. I know some of you in the house, the gold styles or the China style. 老师多讲一点, tell me more. Okay, I give you the meat here. Okay, I do it in one flash. Photo time. Purpose, we're referring to greetings. A one-liner to give a context. List is the details. And take note to reflect what you want them to think or feel. If they are angry, is it, I would be angry too if I were you. If they were happy, is it, I am so happy for you. So again, in the full-day workshop, I'll share with you power phrases on how to acknowledge and reflect the tone in your email. And action, leave it to the final part. Don't put here, put there, and then they will be finding Nemo looking at the actions. Or worse still, they will just do the one thing that you mentioned at the close of the email. And finally, a closing statement. Not just thank you, okay? Your closing statement should gain agreement, express gratitude, or build anticipation. Then you all say, how to start, how to end. I know what you're thinking. I still have 8 minutes. Let me give it all to you. What other interesting ways to start an email? Email openers you like, right? Okay, here's the most common one. Thank you for your email. Thank you for our call. Please draw all the as per our conversation. I refer to your email and for your call. Old fashioned, modern way. Thank you for your tuk tuk tuk. Another one. I love this. This was from a 5-star hotel that I wrote to. I wrote to them to request for some rates. This is in Manila, Shangri-La Hotel. And they replied to me, hi, Maxine. Thank you for connecting with us for your request. Also, connected. Some will say, can I write, thank you for reaching out to us. Reaching out sounds like I just call SOS, like reaching out, I need help. Okay, reaching out sounds a little bit condescending. I don't know, personally, I don't think you should use reaching out. But thank you for connecting with us. Another one. And that one. Another hotel that wrote to me, it is a delight to have this opportunity to support. And I thought, why not? We can all use it as administrators, right? If it is a vendor who approached your boss or your company, or you are helping some of the staff, rather than thank you for your call, it is a delight to have this opportunity to support your, it can be logistics needs, your financial needs, your whatever needs, customized to tata to whatever you're offering. If it is a Monday, then just say, morning. Hope you enjoyed your weekend. Notice I put it as a sentence, and a statement, and not a question. Some of us will write, how was your weekend? What was the problem with that? You will feel obligated to reply, right? The reader will say, oh, she asked me how's my weekend. There's some words still they tell you that about a weekend. Oh, I tell you, I did what on a weekend. Then when you receive the email, you go, I really don't care. So don't ask a question of which you're not prepared to hear and read the long answers. So hope you enjoyed your weekend, period. And the final one. If it is in between the week, don't just start off your email with, as per our conversation. You can start, hope your day, like today is Thursday, right? So you can say, hope your day is going well. If it is like a Tuesday, so many more days in the week, hope your week is going well. Which ones do y'all like and you will start using? Come, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, come, give, show it to me on this. Who is speaking? I hope I don't have to mute you guys. Okay, everybody, let's see. Which ones do y'all want to start using? You all. Okay. There you go. Oops. Thank you. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, let's dive on to the next one. In the next one here, after we have started our email beautifully, how do we close it beautifully? Other than the boring two words, thank you. First one we have. We look forward to our successful collaboration. This is my favorite phrase that I use to close an email, especially for a client who has engaged me to do certain training or work and stuff. So I would say, we look forward. Another one here, have a lovely day, rather than thank you. Or you can say, we look forward to future opportunities. This is when you want to reject them. And then finally, a fourth one, looking forward to hearing from you soon. And finally, looking forward to your prompt response. That means please reply faster. And when they do reply you promptly, your opener can be, thank you for your prompt response. Yay! So there you go. From now on, from today onwards, please drop your boring thank you way to close. There's so many other ways. Which ones will you use? I hope this email finds you well. I hope you're joking, right, Andrew? Because I've been saying it from the start. It is a joke. It is old-fashioned. It's like Finding Nemo. It's like, can I see previous slide? All right, those of you who want to see previous slide, I will move on later, okay? Because I have 4 minutes left. When I've closed this webinar, as in it completed, I'll be happy to rewind my tape to whichever slide you want, okay? Hang on there. Remind me later. I will stay on this chat for 10 minutes after 11:30. Okay, I see so many. There you go. Now, the final 3 to 4 minutes, we will apply our learning. Remember this email, right? As a PA, you rejected an invitation that a company sent to your boss. If you're going to write like that all the time, after a while, your boss will ask, hey, Jenny, how come nobody else inviting me anymore? Don't worry, boss. I turned down all your invitations. I killed them all. Then your boss will like, nobody ever invites me anymore. So this kind of email is very put off. It makes people feel like your boss so important. Huh? He has an important meeting. So why not important, right? Huh? Go ahead. Fine. I'll never, ever invite you again. Then the boss will start wondering, why nobody invited me? So here is the improved version. Let's analyze it together. Because she dear me, I dear her back. So dear Miss Tan. So what someone wrote just now that you write cheers. That is the modern way. Yeah? If you are initiating the email, you hi them and you cheers them. But in this case, she dear me, I dear her back. So take out the full stop, take out the comma. Instead of, see the previous one, I refer to your email. Instead, I write, thank you for your email. Put the month first, the date and the comma. And over here, referring back, I regret to inform you that my boss, who's your boss? I can't remember. And then my boss, Mr. Wong, make sure you put a comma before and after. The simple rule is if you take up Mr. Wong, the sentence still makes sense. So take a look, if Mr. Wong is not here, my boss thanks you. It will make sense, right? If you don't put a comma here, it will become my boss, Mr. Wong. And then if there's no comma, right? My boss, Mr. Wong, thanks you for the... There's no pausing there. So thanks you for your invitation to attend your event. You look here, there was no thank you. There was no appreciation. How do you expect that client to ever want to invite your boss again? And back to the correct one. He wished he could. See, there was no mention of he cannot, regretfully, unfortunately. It sounds like your boss died. Eh? You say he wished he could. And they will get it. That means he cannot. As he has a prior engagement to attend to. Prior is understood that he has been booked. The old way is because he has an important meeting to go. Thank you. You're saying mine is not important. I get it. I get it. But if you say he has a prior engagement. And here comes the powerful closer. The lousy closer is, please do not hesitate to call me. Still want to call you? I will never call you again, you ungrateful. But, thank you. Here's the most boring. Thank you. But here is, we wish you a successful event next week. And here is the powerful closer. Looking forward to your future invitations. You're setting the boss up for future invitations. Unless the boss tells you to cut them out, don't ever accept any of the invitations. Then you say, we look forward to future invitations. They didn't invite you yet. When they invite you, you can still say the same thing. We wish you could. We wish we could. Of course, after a while, if you keep rejecting, they will get it and they will start inviting you. Providing that is your intention. But if at this time your boss really cannot make it, this is a beautiful way. And some will argue, is it regards, best regards, warmest regards, warm regards? Here's the best practice. It's best regards. Okay, that's the best practice. And no need to say call me or to put the number down there so that they will know that that's the number if they should call you, if they want to call you. There's no need to please feel free to call me at this number. You are cluttering your email. Less is more. Dun, 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 dun. Time to take a picture. I am exactly at 11:30. Yay! What do y'all think of this email? Can you give me some feedback? Feedback. That's my final slide already. Yeah? Then I'm going to just share with you. Love it. Thank you. I hope you have taken a picture, because for just 2 more minutes, everybody, just a recap. This is the full day workshop. If you like, that was a taster. It's the tip of the iceberg. I've got so many other useful tips about how do you manage up? How do you manage your boss? How do you organize your time more efficiently? So on and so forth. So as I shared earlier on, well, this whole program, this free webinar is organized by Aventis Learning Group. Oh, that's me. I see my happy student. Ooh. Oh my God, I'm wearing the same jacket. You like my mustard jacket? Ooh. You like my new watch too? Okay, enough of flashing. And this, some of us have given feedback in the survey that Aventis did. They say that, but I don't have time to match their schedule. So this is something that I've created before the whole COVID-19 and all the circuit breaker that came about, right? And that's standalone. You can buy the e-learning program, and that's where you can learn it at your own cost, at your own pace. Of course, get your boss to pay for it. And it's usually priced at $300, but for today's attendees, because we have registered with Aventis, if you sign up today, or before the 5th or on the 5th of June or earlier, you get a discount. And all Singaporeans love discount. And that's where you can call. I hope you take a picture of this right now. Carmen is our lovely colleague here. She will answer all your questions. How do you sell it? And then how do you buy it for the company? And all of you can watch it. The whole video is me. Y'all can feel my style, right? Even e-learning, I'm like super animated. And of course, as I promised, I have recommended to split a one-day program into 2 half days. So in the morning, y'all can clear all your admin work. And the afternoon, you can party with me and learn something at the same time. So can you please scan this QR code, and you will get a special prize, and it will be on the 17th and 18th June, Wednesday and Thursday. See, I must remind Aventis to put the month first, right? To put the date first. So it's 2 p.m. to 5 p.m., right? 3 hours with a break in between. So if you like, please join us. There's so much more I'd like to learn, I would like to share with you. And as promised, I will stay on this chat group for the next 10 minutes. And those of you who want me to flash back the slides, just tell me. But while I do that, I'd like you all to, I'm going to share my lovely music. Woo-hoo. Y'all like to see my playlist, right? Well, this is my favorite closing song. Bring it all back. I call it the graduation song. All right, bring on your questions. Thank you, everybody. Be safe. Be positive. I hope to see you again for my final tomorrow, and of course the upcoming quarter. Love you all! Thank you so much. You're welcome. It's planned how much information is provided. Yeah.
got. Let the world see what you have got. Bring it all back to you.
Bring it all back
to you. Plan on purpose. How much information do you provide on the new subject without overlapping content? Rule of thumb. Example, what program on the logistics? You need to write the logistics. All right, okay, now we have, thank you so much. Any other questions, y'all can ask me. I'll just verbalize. The background is drowning your voice. Oh, I wasn't going to talk, Shuxian. That's why I'm typing it out for you. I was just speaking as I'm typing. You see? Yes, Sally, can you flash the slides? Modern rules on business writing. Of course, that is my very first slide. So let me exit in all the way here. Thank you. There you go. And three simple rules. You're welcome, Shuxian. Can you flash this? Okay, modern, that's for Sally. Okay, may I know which other courses do you hold? Okay, thank you, Emmeline. Let me write it down. Emmeline. For Aventis, I have negotiation skills for an all-win result. I have managing difficult people. Oh, that's my showcase tomorrow. If you can join me, it's at 2:30, right? And I have a full day workshop on that. Third one is a communicate to influence. And the fourth one, I have this course, right? The secretary one. And then I have thinking on your feet. All these I've also done showcases. And okay, what else do I have? And number five is Shine Your True Colors, which I also did a showcase with good people skills. There you go. Let's see. Can you flash? Okay, see you. See you tomorrow. Oh, Priscilla, thank you. I'll see you tomorrow, Priscilla. Tomorrow will be great for everyday life, especially everyone is so difficult now. They expect you to be king, queen, and bao ka liao, bao sua, bao hai. Your children expect you to be super moms, even though you have to cook and then do your work. So yes, you will find tomorrow's session extremely useful. I wish to get my organization to sponsor the course. Oh yes, May. Please contact. Thank you for your support. Now let me thank you first. Thank you for your support. Please contact Carmen. Yep. Regarding the customized program, I call it the bespoke programs. More atas. Okay, let me flash for you. Carmen's contact. Carmen's contact is here. Okay. Okay, you see Carmen's contact there. Thank you for. And how to join Marie? Can you flash slide in modern writing? Oh, Stephanie, you need that again. Okay, Marie. When you say how to join, are you talking about how to join my courses? If yes, can you visit their website? They have all the courses and the dates. And Stephanie, hold on for a second, okay? I just explained to Marie first. Tomorrow's course is managing difficult customers, applicable for, it's for everything, my dear Emmeline. Could be day-to-day with your colleagues, with your bosses, with your children, with the people in your life, because anyone can be difficult, right? So the big answer is yes. Thank you. We'll contact Carmen. Have a good day. Yes. Then I must. Yeah, you must. Okay, let me do for Stephanie. Modern writing. Okay. Stephanie, coming right up. Yeah, these three simple rules will change your whole mindset about email writing. That's for you, Stephanie. You're welcome, Stephanie. Welcome, Stephanie. Welcome, Emmeline. And who else on the group? Not this one. Okay, which one, Stephanie? Modern. Oh, you mean the, oh, I get you. The old-fashioned and the modern one, right? I have two slides on this. So this is the first one. Is it this one, Stephanie? I think you will mention, yes. Not this one, correct ones. Correct. What do you mean, S? Could you retype that? It's CORRESCYES. Are you seeing this next one? Is this the second one? Yes. Oh, I think this message came in late. You meant this one, right? So did you get the first one? Do you want me to flash back the first one? First one, correct. Okay, go back. All right, let me scroll back. Did I miss anything? So thank you, Mei Chong. Let me take a picture for Carmen so she knows. Okay, Mei Chong. Please contact. I'm texting Carmen right now so that she can be proactive. Mei Chong. See, that's when this opportunity, you grab it. And let's see what else. Can I see the email or letter template for me to take a photo? Of course, I give my love freely because I'm paying it forward. Although I didn't invent this. I know a lot of trainers, speakers like, no, copyright and all that. Please not. If you will use it, I'll be happy, you know, use it. And then the world will be much better and we can all understand one another better. And whatever I give, I will create new ones. So I'm never afraid to give away. Can I see the email? Okay, take photo. Mm-hmm. Are you referring to the Shirley, Miss Shirley Quack? This is the email template. Or do you want the actual email that I have the corrected version? There's another one as well. This is the one that's the template. And are you referring to my perfect email? This is the perfect email. Because there's only one slide where I show you the PLAN. Oh, thank you, Nancy. You're most welcome. Oh, insightful and interactive sessions. You touched my heart. Thank you, Shirley. Thank you, Nancy. And Shirley just said thank you too. Thank you, Nancy, for your compliments. And you are welcome, Shirley. All right, we have a couple more minutes. So let's see. Oh, we are 15 minutes extra. So Abigail, just one more minute. All right, Abigail is my colleague from Aventis. She's waiting to shut this. So final question, anybody? If no, take care. Thank you, Emmeline. See you tomorrow. See you, everyone. Join me. Have a lovely Thursday. Thursday is the new Friday. Till we meet again. Ta-da! Thank you, Abigail. Wait, I must do this. It's a wrap. I love that. Bye now.